West Virginia at Connecticut. This is Friday night ESPN. Marco, what should batters be looking at?
Last week, both teams had clunkers for games. I think both teams were looking ahead. And the fact that we had low-scoring games from both teams last week, it's going to give us great value for the total, and that's where my play is going to be in this video.
So you like the over?
I like the over.
All right, so let's talk about, because this is one thing that you preach about a lot that I agree with. Sometimes we disagree. I agree 100%. The public believes their eyes. In the last video, you were talking about, oh, everyone's gotten more sophisticated. You know, to be honest with you, I'm not so sure how much that is. I think it's changed a little bit by 10% or whatever. I think in general, when someone sees a team lose, what was it, 26-0, UConn lost, then they think this team stinks and this team can't score.
Right.
And West Virginia, how many points they have last week?
The score was like 19-14. It was a low
score. They can't score, good defense. Now, wow, that adds up to an under. And unless there's a reason not to, that's the way to look because you're probably gaining a few points. So other than just the public perception, are there other factors that incline you towards the over?
Well, I like the Connecticut coach, Edsel. He's a guy that whenever he is played on these TV games, you know, excitement. He has some trickery, you know, and I like the fact you're on a Friday night. If this was a regular Saturday game amongst the rest of the card, I wouldn't be doing it. But because it is that game where it's going to be in the public eye, there's going to be a lot of action, and like you said, people are going to bet with their eyes. I look at this game and find the value. Since Edsel took over at Connecticut, he's a perfect 7-0 against the spread. Just an interesting stat. When they were held to single digits the week before. Obviously, they were shut out, so they were held to single digits. In those nine games, the average total points was 50 points for those nine games after they were held to single digits. So he knows how to make the changes and come back and score points.
All right, so let me ask you, because it begs the question for the people who watched our prior Thursday night video, is you spent 3 minutes saying how you don't like trends in college. So in this case, what about this trend makes it an exception?
This is a shorter-term trend because you're talking about a coach that's only been there, you know, a few years, the program, the Connecticut program.
And for those that didn't watch, the reason that you don't like trends in college is the turnover in personnel on the player side.
Correct. What this does tell me is giving a trend that's a coach-related trend.
Okay.
We're looking
so
at
you like coach-related trends, especially when the span of the trend has one coach within it.
Right.
All right, that makes a ton of sense. Go ahead.
So he knows how to make adjustments, gets his team, fixes problems. You know, obviously that doesn't carry over into the next week with a number like that, because not only is it, you know, a double-edged, you know, number, he's not only scoring points the next week, they're 7-0 against the spread, you know. So it's a good number. It's solid. It's a basis.
So we got a good coach who likes to bounce back. Or does well bouncing back. We have a coach that does well in prime time and gets excited about prime time. We have two teams that were likely looking ahead to this big game last week, had underperformed in a way that tends towards the under. That means value.
And to me, that all adds up to me making a play on this game. And
give us your official projection.
I'm looking at this game to go over the total. I see West Virginia being able to squeak out a win, 28-24, but that gets us over the number. The total sitting right now at 45
All
and
right.
a half.
Couple of closing thoughts. This is interesting. West Virginia is 11-0 ATS on the road against a losing home team. So let's think about that a second. The typical flat spot that a team has is, all right, you're a pretty good team. You're on the road, but you're against a losing team, and thus you end up winning by three. You were laying seven or whatever. Mm-hmm. That happens all the time. That's a typical flat spot. So it looks like West Virginia is one of those teams that is good enough to win on the road, but not so good that they take it for granted. Mm-hmm. And if you think about it, if you have a motivated, one of the things about home field is two things. One is the home crowd's excited, but oftentimes if it's a losing home team, there is no home, you know, there's 3,000 people or 7,000, you know, the crowd's not really a factor. Number two is if the team who's traveling is flat because they're taking the game for granted against a bad team or something, that's another reason that home dogs do well. The home field advantage and the flatness of the road team. If you have a West Virginia that's not flat, then it seems like they're going to do well on the road against bad teams. And 11-0 is a pretty big number.
Now, how far did that go back?
You know, I'm not sure on that. But what was your point?
The point would be, the only thing that I would put in there is, remember, we're only, this is the third year we're into the coach at West Virginia that we have now. So 11-0, that definitely is pretty much all him.
See, I wouldn't think, because think about it, if you're playing five or six road games a year, and you're only going to, West Virginia is only going to be a road favorite in two or three at most, this probably does extend back 4 years or more, I would say.
Okay.
So I would agree with you. But again, to me, if the majority is from the current coach, and again, there's a culture. Is this West Virginia's been a, when they've been good, a top 25 but not above 15 team, typically, mm-hmm. there's been exceptions, and that seems to fit the model here, a pretty good team that doesn't take bad home teams for granted.
The only reason, the point that I was getting at with that is going back to Rodriguez, which we're seeing that at Michigan, it's an offensive-minded coach that the defense was secondary, and when you're playing on the road, you're laying a shorter number, so that offense, you know, at home you're laying a big number, and a lot of times that defense will give you up backdoor covers with a bigger spread, where when you're on the road, you're laying generally in that single-digit range.
Offense will give you the backdoor cover.
If you have a bad defense and you're laying a lot of points at home.
Oh, give up the backdoor
right.
cover. Okay.
So when you're playing on the road and you got a good offense, but you're laying a smaller number on the road, so you're still getting that win and not worrying about that backdoor cover as much.
Because if the backdoor touchdown happens, they might lose the game
right.
because of the shorter number. Last point is West Virginia's covered 5 of 6 against UConn. And again, like we said, there's been a coaching change there. But I think when it comes to matchup stats, oftentimes that actually transcends, when it's a matchup between the two specific teams, it oftentimes transcends the coach. Okay, good stuff. All right, now it's your turn to continue the conversation in the comments section with Marco and me. And next up, and this is the last video, or actually the last audio on this podcast, so our next podcast is coming up, and our next video, and we're going to be talking about this weekend's college and pro football action.